and welcome to TeenHQ DIY. Today we are talking about Dia de Muertos Ofrendas. Now a lot of people say Dia de los Muertos, and that's fine too. The extra word is more of the English version of it. So just thought I'd throw that out there. I had originally written Dia de los Muertos, and the more and more that I read, the more and more I felt like I needed to take the loss out. So you will get, just like last time, you will get a kit, and you will get a booklet with your kit. If you sign up online, you have to register for this on our events and program calendar under Find Stuff, I believe, on our website. So inside of your booklet, you're going to find a lot of information about Dia de Muertos. You're going to find the history of it, and there is a lot of history. I found it fascinating, and when I was working on the booklet, I kept reading and reading and reading, and I then wanted to know about, like, all of the Aztec beliefs, and I went down a rabbit hole. It was a whole thing, so I hope you do too, because it's a lot of fun. You will find out about the land of the dead, which is where the Aztecs believed that people went after they died. But they also believed that it took them 4 years to travel through these 9 levels of the underworld. And in order to get from that first level down, they had to complete some different challenges, which I found absolutely fascinating because there's like this wind that blows at you and it feels like knives. But if you've been buried with a blanket, you can make it through a lot easier. There's a, what is he called? He's a dog. There's a man with a dog head who's a psychopomp is another term for him, who will lead you, help lead you through those 9 levels of the underworld as well. And so then once they finally get to the bottom layer, they will meet, I'm calling her May, Queen May. it's Mictlan, something along those lines. I cannot pronounce it. So I decided to call her Queen May. She is the queen of the dead. And she helps to bring the, she basically eats the soul and then sends it back up to earth. And she is also guarding the bones of the dead. So she is someone that during the Day of the Dead or the celebration of the dead, everyone is honoring her. They are also honoring their ancestors. And so they want to make sure that they can get through those 9 levels more comfortably. So on the Day of the Dead, or as it was originally honored, is celebrated in August, but then the Spaniards came and there was the whole conquest of Southern America and Central America, which is kind of sad. there was a lot of destroying of temples and religion, but they were able to, the Aztecs were able to hold on to a lot of those traditions, and they merged with the Spanish traditions. And now, instead of being celebrated in August, Dia de Muertos is celebrated between October 31st and November the 2nd. So you'll learn all of those things and a lot more when you read your booklet. But I wanted to make sure you at least had that base knowledge so you knew why we were talking about what we're talking about. So on October 31st, it is said that the veil between the dead and the living is smaller. It's that way with All Hallows Eve and Samhain as well. But it's very different than Halloween. So make sure you keep that in mind when you're working on this or even just when you're talking to other people. Halloween and Day of the Dead are very, very different things, but they also have a lot of similarities. So they're both about the dead, but really when people are wearing costumes and scary face masks for Halloween, what they're trying to do is scare away the spirits of the dead and the bad spirits. Whereas with the Mexican and Southern America, or Mesoamerica is what they called it then, religions, they are celebrating their ancestors and helping them on their journey. So you will find a lot of things put together on an altar or an ofrenda for the Day of the Dead. So on the first Day of the Dead, so you had October 31st where that veil has thinned. And then on that day, it is said that Queen May, as we're calling her, will bring the ancestors with her for this Day of the Dead. And on the first day, it's known as the Day of the Infants, basically Day of the Little Angels, or Angelitos. And that is when they celebrate the lives of infants and children who have died. So on that night, and for 24 hours, those ancestors are supposed to come on November the 1st. And then on November the 2nd, that's when the adult ancestors come to visit. So on both days, they make ofrendas, they have celebrations, they dance, they mock the idea of death because they believe in a cyclical life. So they believe that you are reincarnated. So they kind of, they in many terms, in many places, they say, we mock death. We are making fun of it because we don't think that it is a concrete thing, which I thought was kind of interesting too. So in order to honor these people, they create an altar or an ofrenda. And on your ofrenda, you're going to have several things. So in your kit, you're going to get several parts of an ofrenda, but you'll be able to make the rest of it on your own. So you're going to get some construction paper to help you create a box. There will be instructions on how to do that as well. And then if you want to, you could use a shoebox. I just brought a shoebox from home because I thought it would be a lot easier than trying to put together a cardstock box. But if you don't have a shoebox or another box like that, a cardstock box can be a great option too. I also will be including two of these little fun skulls that came from the Dollar Tree. So if you want some extras, you could go to the Dollar Tree and get those there. You can paint them and make them look like sugar skulls, or there are other kinds of skulls that they have around too. You can use marker as well, or paint markers that would do great too. So the first thing that you need to have for your kit, for your ofrenda, is marigolds or cempasuchil. I know I said that wrong, but they're marigolds. And they are a flower that's easily recognizable because of their color. They're bright orange yellow, and they have a very strong fragrance. So those are used to invite your ancestors in, as well as to give them a way into the altar or the ofrenda. So you want to make sure that those are there. They also are often used to decorate graves, and they are used in medicinal purposes, which I thought was interesting. One of the very most important things for you to have is called pan de muerto, which is bread of the dead. So they make a sweet bread, and it is a crisscross and heart-shaped bread. And this is because, this one's kind of morbid, guys, I'm sorry. This is because back in the day, in the Aztec days, they would sacrifice people, and they usually would cut out the heart and put that on the ofrenda. And that's gross. So the Spaniards came across and were like, we don't want to be like killing people or mutilating people when we're honoring them. So instead, why don't we make this bread? It's shaped like a heart. You can paint it red, and it's just like you cut out somebody's heart. Same thing, right? No, not really. But I thought that was fascinating, and they do want you to make sure that you have that sweet bread, and it's usually near the top of the altar. So that the ancestors can get to it. It's the only time during the year that it is sold is during Dia de los Muertos, which I thought was cool. You also want to make sure that you have candles. Candles represent hope and faith, and usually there's three or four. Sometimes if you have four candles, it'll represent north, south, east, and west, to help your ancestors get oriented on where they are in their journey. Another thing that's very important to have is incense. Now, we're not going to give you incense this time, but it is very easy to find. But they use this special kind that you can't really find around here. It's mostly found in Mexico, and it's called copal incense, and they put that there so that the spirits could enter without difficulty because it helped cleanse the air. And then next, there is papel picado, which is this bright, fun paper like these. And I'm just going to show you some of the tissue paper that you will get inside of your kit. And then you can cut them out into like elaborate pictures of skeletons and pumpkins and animals. Usually they're dancing, or you can just, there's printables of those as well where you can trace it on. They do say to have this tissue-like paper so that it can blow in the wind, because you're trying to represent fire with the candles, earth with your food, wind with the papel picado, and then you'll want to have a small cup of water on your ofrenda as well. That's very important because water symbolizes the purity of the soul and the source of life. And then there's two more things you need to have. So you need to have your sugar skulls, which I said you're going to get your two skulls in there. You can also make them out of sugar, and I will be including a recipe for those. And then personal objects. So you want to make sure that you have something of your ancestors on your ofrenda. So I went ahead and brought along, you want photographs. So I brought a couple photographs of my grandfather who passed away. That one is him with me as a baby, and this is him when he was in the military. He also loved frogs, so we've got that little frog toy. I have some chocolate because you always need some food for your journey. I have a guitar key ring because he loved to play the guitar, and he wrote music as well. So that's why there's a little composition notebook. So that's just to help invite in your ancestors as well as to show them that you love them and that you're thinking about them on their journeys. And that, I believe, is it. So you're going to have this really cool kit that you can put together. Remember that Dia de Muertos is celebrated between October the 31st and November the 2nd. So you'll have plenty of time to create your own ofrenda. And once you pick up your kit can be picked up after October the 7th. You will get an email from me. The 14th, October the 14th, you'll get an email from me letting you know that the kits are ready to pick up, and you can watch this video that day as well in order to learn more about it. I think that's it for today. I hope that you have learned something about Dia de Muertos and about other cultures, and I hope you have a lot of fun making your ofrendas. Bye!